Hello to you, friends. This is what Buddha said, number 5, on the Untamed Mind, the Sutta number 5 in the Anguttara Nikaya, the numerical sayings of the Buddha. But first, the normal intro. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the best Buddha. Indeed. And again, it's from the numerical sayings of the Buddha, the Anguttara Nikaya, Book of Ones, Sutta number 5, Untamed, Adanta. At Savatthi, the blessed Buddha said this: Bhikkhus, I know of not even one other thing leading to so much harm as the untamed mind. The untamed mind, Bhikkhus, is of great disadvantage. Bhikkhus, I know of not even one other thing leading to so much good as the tamed mind. The tamed mind, Bhikkhus, is of great advantage. Bhikkhus, I perceive not even one other phenomenon bringing so great misery as the unguarded mind. The unguarded mind, Bhikkhus, is very damaging. Bhikkhus, I perceive not even one other phenomenon bringing so great benefit as the guarded mind. The guarded mind, Bhikkhus, is very beneficial. Bhikkhus, I see not even one other state bringing so great loss as the unprotected mind. Such unshielded mind, Bhikkhus, leads to much misery. Bhikkhus, I see not even one other state bringing such great gain as the protected mind. Such sheltered mind, Bhikkhus, brings great benefit. Bhikkhus, I comprehend not even one other thing producing so much evil as the uncontrolled mind. The uncontrolled mind, Bhikkhus, is very dangerous. Bhikkhus, I comprehend not even one other thing conducive to so much welfare as the controlled mind. The controlled mind, Bhikkhus, is very advantageous. Bhikkhus, I know of no other single thing leading to so much away from the goal as the untamed, unguarded, unprotected, and uncontrolled mind. Such untamed, unguarded, unprotected, and uncontrolled mind misses any aim. Bhikkhus, I know of no other single thing leading to so direct approach to the goal as a tamed, guarded, protected, and controlled mind. Such tamed, guarded, protected, and controlled mind reaches whatever aim. And some comments on this untamed mind, speech. Untamed means a mind that has not brought to the forces of greed, hate, and confusion under control. So, lobha, dosa, moha, greed, hate, and ignorance is not under control. When this is not under control, then the mind is untamed. It runs into problems because it doesn't see because of ignorance. is attracted to evil, evil things because of desire and greed. And it runs right into even more evil things because of hate, anger, irritation. Tamed means a mind which has subdued these destructive forces of greed, hate, and ignorance. Unguarded means a mind which is unaware of itself and blinded as to its own activities. So it's a mind that doesn't see what it do. It's a mind that is on autopilot. Thereby it becomes a monkey mind when it's still under influence of greed, hate, and ignorance. It watches neither what is coming through the sense doors, it doesn't see the input, nor what is going out through the doors of thought, speech, and action, it doesn't see the output. So it is blind both to the input and to the output. How can such a computer be in control? It's impossible. As it does not deliberately and systematically evaluate what is appearing at the door of the eye, the ear, the nose, the tongue, the body, and the mind, it is unable to recognize, sort out, and control any detrimental inputs. As it does not deliberately and systematically evaluate what is going out through the five doors, it is unable to prevent the expression of detrimental thought, speech, and action. Such mind is therefore inevitably vulnerable and prone to these quite painful effects of these actions. Neglect is the bad root also here. So when mind doesn't see what's come in through the five sense doors, the eye, the ear, the nose, the tongue, the body, and eventually also the mind. Thoughts, souls are six senses here. And it doesn't see what comes out through thinking, through speech, and through physical action. Then whatever effects there is of both, whether advantageous or detrimental, it doesn't see, it doesn't aware. It's not aware of it. Because it's not aware of it, it doesn't evaluate what comes in or what goes out. Because it's not evaluated systematically, scrutinized it, then it cannot discriminate, it cannot control. So to suppress the disadvantages, the detrimental inputs and outputs, it cannot cut off. Nor can it enhance, increase, make come into being the advantageous inputs and outputs. For example, listening to Dhamma talks and acting verbally, mentally, and physically in accordance with the Dhamma. It cannot do that because it is unguarded and untamed. Guarded means a mind which continuously watches, notes, and evaluates both sense inputs and action output. Thus, it is able to prevent detrimental, disadvantageous inputs such as porn movies, overeating, drugging, boozing, giving rise to these disadvantageous mental states such as greed and anger. Therefore, it is able to prevent disadvantageous outputs through the doors of thought, speech, and action, which result in future delayed pain through the karmic ego effect. In this way, such a mind guards and protects itself and others also simultaneously against otherwise inevitably painful consequences. Continuous and alert awareness is a good root also here. Unprotected means a mind not covered like by an umbrella, not shielded as by a screen, against suddenly arising and incoming states of lust, jealousy, irritation, impatience, aversion, intolerance, arrogance, stubbornness, conceit, laziness, restlessness, shamelessness, doubt and confusion. Protected means a mind covered by acute awareness of all arising mental states and shielded by recognition and evaluation of their moral character and discrimination and clear comprehension of their causes, what make these states come into being. Uncontrolled means a mind which is unable to resist any temptation, nor able to restrain any aversion. It means a mind unable to recognize speculative views as speculative views, and a mind unable to recognize skeptical doubt as skeptical doubt. Controlled means a mind which is fully able to recognize and overcome sudden impulses of desire. It perceives and calms sudden impulses of aversion, and it discriminates views as views, and knowledge as knowledge. Examine what is doubtful and follow what is certain and safe. It can evaluate all states right when they arise. So, whatever sensation that is advantageous is ceased. Whatever experiences that are detrimental, it ceases and is aware of it. Whatever experiences that are neutral, it ceases and is aware of it. So it can evaluate all planned mental, verbal and bodily actions, thereby making them advantageous and not detrimental. Skal katten ud? The cat has to go out, yeah. And with releasing the cat to its nightly toilet path, we hereby end the speech on the untamed mind, Adanta, from the Anguttara Nikaya, in the Numerical speeches of the Buddha. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. Thank you to all Dayakas, supporters, and donors. Thank you for your attention, clever consideration, and contribution, and have a nice day. Thank you.
You heard Bhikkhu Samahita from the Cypress Hermitage on the Knuckles Mountain, Bambarella, Central Hill Country, Sri Lanka. Please subscribe to the Google group Buddha Direct and visit the website whatbuddhasaid.net. May all beings become thus happy thereby. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. As the next Buddha, the noble Arya Ajitamitaya will say, you can come as you like, but you pay as you go. Thank you for your contribution and have a nice day.